to the Lakeside Club and the final of the Embassy Darts Championship of the World. Once again, every seat in this remarkable arena has been filled, and at some point during the next couple of hours, a Welshman or a Scot will become the champion of the world and with it collect a cheque for £38,000. This is where Marshall James and Les Wallace will be standing, precisely 7'9¼", or 2.37 metres, away from the board. On this day of all days, they'll be hoping that their hand remains steady and that their aim is true. Here's how they reach the final.
...114, double six. Yes! Oh, what a lovely finish! Single nine leaves him double eight. Two darts to go, double eight for the match. Tension at the fingertips. Treble 20, double 14. Double 14 for the match. On to go. It's there. Look at the joy. Treble 20 to lead 46. 86 left. Treble 18 could be. He's a dart now for the match. And it's double 16, the best double on the board. It's there! What a match! You won't see better. Look at smiles from Beaton. But what a great match. Marshall James is in the final. For the 19s first. Yes, 57, 58 left. Double top for the match. Oh, yes. Unbelievable. What a performance from Scotland. Two treble 20s. The best left-hander in the world, moving across the hockey, looking to put another one in there. Steady it down, Alice. Hit that ball. Yes! It's there! Carroll standing! Everyone standing! A 170 out shot! We're placing the semi-final. Double 10. Double 5.
Game, shot, and the match, Les Wallace.
He's in the semi-final. Double 16 for the match.
Game, shot, and the match, Les Wallace.
Well, look at the scenes here. The Wallace family, the man himself, the pride of Scotland, is in the final.
Yes, they both had some adventures along the way, but the greatest adventure of all is just about to begin. It's Wales against Scotland in the final, Marshall James against Les Wallace. Now, one of the great features about this championship is that all the players do tend to stay on throughout the week. It's not a case of going home after you've been knocked out. And earlier today, Tony Green spoke to some of the competitors in this year's World Championship and asked them who they thought would win the title.
Well, I think if Les can handle the ways that Marshall's so slow and produce the darts he's been playing all week, Les, I think he's got a good chance of winning it. But if Marshall keeps his consistency up the way he's been doing it, he's going to win it.
Les, he's beaten some of the best players, but you can't take it away from Marshall as well. It's been a tough competition. But I just see Les pipping Marshall to take the title.
Do you think the slow play is going to affect Les?
It affected me a bit, but I mean, like we know, Les, he don't show no emotion or expressions or anything, so maybe it won't affect Les. Maybe Les will just get his head down and play, you know. But I mean, there again, Marshall's playing well, so even if Les does get his head down, maybe Marshall will pick his game up as well, yeah.
Marshall's playing exceptionally well, and so is Les. I just hope Les can cope with the speed that Marshall plays. Otherwise, that might be a little bit one-sided.
On paper, you've got to look at Les Wallace with his experience of travelling Europe and stuff, but Marshall James has surprised everybody. I mean, he's playing some wonderful darts.
Is it Wells?
I've got to go, I think, with Scotland, maybe. The experience just might do it.
Well, we've seen two great players this week. They've come through the tournament. They've come through very well. They've given us great darts. But if I was a betting man, I think I would go for Les Wallace, for his experience, if nothing else.
Well, the players seem pretty unanimous that it's going to be Les Wallace, and in fact the bookies agree with them. So let's get the thoughts of the two players who are with me now. They both know what it's all about to reach the final of the World Championship. Bobby George and, of course, Leighton Rees. Leighton, this is the 20th Embassy. You won the first. Does it seem like that long ago?
It doesn't really seem like 20 years ago, Dougie, but I don't know.
A Welshman won it then, but is a Welshman going to win it today? This is the big question.
Without a shadow of doubt.
Why do you say that?
Because he's Welsh, for the start. He's also a good player, and Les is a very good player as well, but I think the Welsh player will win the game.
You've been impressed with Marshall this week, obviously. He seems a very calm sort of individual.
Cool and Luke. Yeah? Mm. Well, Marshall's played for Wales a couple of years ago and then retired for a while and come back, but he seems to have the right attitude and the will to win, which takes him. Right. And I just wish that them all the best. I'm sure he will do Wales proud.
As we look out about this terrific scene, as everyone awaits the start of the final, let's just take you back to that first final, Leighton. In 1977, the very first Embassy Darts Championship of the world. It was Eric Bristow in the final, wasn't it?
No, John Lowe.
John Lowe, that's right.
The other Englishman. Double top, I believe.
What was the winning check?
50, 10 double top.
Not bad.
I remember it well.
And now here we are at the 20th Embassy. Eric Bristow, of course, is the man who beat you in your first final, Bobby. That's what I was thinking of in 1980. How do you see this afternoon's final going?
They're two different sorts of players. As Marshall is a very robotic, sure of himself player. He's a lot slower than most players you meet in the circuit, so he can be off point, but he's accurate. The worst thing playing a slow player is when they're very accurate as well. But Les is a type of guy that he doesn't seem to bother him that much. He's like walking up the hockey, taking his darts out like he's picking flowers in his garden. He doesn't get wound up, doesn't get upset. He's so pleased to be in the final, and I hope we have a great game of darts today. Not just a Welshman win or a Scotsman, but darts to win. That's the main thing. As long as we have a good game. I'll go for Les then.
You backing the Scotsman?
Well, not
English me. Backing the Scotsman?
Yeah, no, my mother is Scottish, you see. You didn't know that.
Well, the first ceremony of the final has already taken place. That, of course, is the draw for the darts in the first set. And that draw was conducted just a few minutes ago by BDO official Sam Hawkins.
Right, good luck, Marshall.
Okay, Sam. Okay.
Good luck, Les.
Thanks,
sir. Right, it's Marshall to draw the ball. And the green ball will go first. Right, so Les will throw first.
All the best, Les.
So Les will have the darts and the chance of taking that crucial early advantage in the first of our scheduled 11 sets. Leighton, you of course came very close to qualifying again for this year. Tell us about the standard generally of darts today.
Well, I actually think I'm close. I lost the second round, but
that's pretty close.
That's pretty close, yeah. Well, the standard keeps going up and up every year. Obviously, you think it might just it'll never drop, and it's just amazing that a couple of years back, if you were to somebody from outside the British Isles, it was more or less.
Yes.
Win, but now it's totally changed as well. since John Part won it, and
That's the big change, I think, Bobby, isn't it? That the overseas players are now every bit as good as most of the British players, aren't they?
The overseas players get the BBC television, so they watch this programme and they think, God, I could be world champion, I could be in the embassy, why don't I go into tournaments? And every year they get better and better because they all want to do it. Mm. It shows that a qualifier's got to the final again, and that's what's good for darts. They haven't closed the door, the BDO, to the world. They've opened the door for every player to have a chance to be world champion. And that's what I want to be one day.
There's the pictures backstage then. Les Wallace obviously in the kilt, the Scot. He's based in Southampton, but you won't find a more patriotic Scot. And in the background there, Marshall James, who of course had to come through that same qualifying competition that Leighton was talking about to make his way here to the Lakeside. So the players are ready. The crowd is certainly ready. Let's enjoy every dart live in this year's World Championship final. They're playing for the trophy and for £38,000. Let's hand you over to our MC here at the Lakeside, Martin Fitzmaurice.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's play darts! The 1997 Embassy World Professional Darts Championship Final. Please welcome the Welsh wizard, Marshall James. Ladies and gentlemen, the pride of Scotland, Les
Wallace. The scene is set, the ceremony's over, it's time for the real business of this World Championship final to begin. To describe it for you, John Part and Tony Green.
Well, thank you, Doogie. Here we are in the hot seat. And just listening to Leighton, well, if you go back 20 years, he received £3,000. That was the title money then. Today, it's £38,000. And the other thing, John, Leighton didn't remark that it's the first time England have ever met Scotland in a final.
Wales and Scotland.
Wales and Scotland.
Yes, and I guess there's historically probably a rivalry there that I'm not aware of, but two very proud nations, and the support here should be intense from both sides. Quite a bit of noise from the gallery, I imagine.
Well, I think the excitement's already building. You could feel it. And these are practice darts, by the way, and I think we've got plenty of time with Marshall because he throws just the same speed in practice as he will in the match. That's what they're playing for. That's more important than the money, I can guarantee you that. Embassy World Professional Championship, the title every player dreams of taking in his lifetime. And if we look for crowds, well, once again, as always, from day one, when we arrived here 9 days ago, capacity. Marshall James. As Leighton said, Cool and Luke. Many nicknames. They're going to be exploding throughout this match. We're all set.
The very best of order. First set, first leg, Les to throw first.
Well, this is it. Already cheers ring out for Scotland's Les Wallace. First leg. To remind you, it's the best of 11 sets, the final.
£100.
There's Marshall James Three dart average of 88.62 so far. Les Wallace, 95.54. Very impressive. But look at that, 100 plus shots. Marshall James at 181. Les Wallace, 102. The other two look pretty even though, Tony.
Well, it's consistency, isn't it? May take him a little time, a couple of legs to settle in, get that range.
43.
The other thing, John, between them, 31 eighties, 15 apiece.
Yes, the nerves will play a bit of a part at this stage.
60.
The entrance, as a player, I had the experience to enter a final, and it really gets your heart beating. Represent your country in the walk onto that stage. So they may need to settle down a bit.
Especially with all the players there lining up. What an entry.
Well, as you mentioned, Tony, first time Wales, Scotland. In fact, it's only the second final ever without an English player.
Yes, I think I recall that. And a Welshman took that, didn't he, Burnett? Against Barneveld. Best left-hander in the world.
100.
And there's little Georgie Noble. He's a star in his own right. Now is Georgie, the puppy. See by his tie. Don't know if it's a mongrel. The concentration. The accuracy.
190.
We're in the first leg, John, a maximum.
Marshall really needed it there.
You'll hear the silence when the players are throwing. That is great support.
81. Leisure require 141.
He's been taking some high out shots. Well, 170. That's already worth £1,600. They did the treble though. 101. And they come down. Dune.
97. Marshall required 97.
An opportunity against the darts here. Treble 7, treble 19, excuse me. Well, there's a 3, so I need a treble 18 to leave double 20. So that's 76, treble 20 to leave double 8.
41.
A better finish coming in.
44.
With the first bit of excitement other than the 180. Maybe 12, but he prefers double top, and that's what he's going for.
James Shaw, and the first leg, Les Wallace.
Well, there's Carroll, there's the danger.
Second leg, Marshall, throw first. Game on.
First double to Scotland. He's quite partial to doubles, John, is Wallace.
Well, there we see Marshall James throwing 156 at double, hit 60, 38.46. Les Wallace throwing 104, hit 53, more than half, 50.96%. Outstanding finishing.
Les was in the semi-final, so the experience, certainly with him.
96.
Last year's semi-finalist. But I think John with a abundance of players coming through. No, I mean, we're not talking just about over here in Great Britain, we're talking around the world.
Yes, it's every player's aspiration throughout the world for this, to play in this tournament even.
And, 100!
once a player gets a chance, well, I think they'll play their best.
...64 points behind.
...60!
The Marshalls... ...puff to the final against Steve Beaton. The match... 2.5 hours. Exhausting.
...140!
And this has become a popular camera, John. Cyclops looking down the hockey.
Looks like a great view of how the darts are thrown. It's the best perspective to see the actual stance and delivery. You can see how the arm is straight from the... It comes straight from the eye of the dart, right over the top. Look at the results.
140!
Very well described, John.
And we see Marshall. He has very rigid arm movement. Just the one movement, just to push the dart.
And the time in his semi-final match was around about 20, 22 seconds. He's on the finish, 116, and out shot for Les.
66.
A bit unfortunate.
116.
Yes. Nice little out shot, 116. He'll be on the 20s. Treble. Yes, 56. Likes double top, so 16. Right in the middle. The single, now double top.
Game shot, and a second leg. Marshall Jones.
Well, there's no nerves there.
Third leg, Les to throw first. Game on.
Comfortable finish there, John, wasn't it? 1-1-6, right in the middle.
Well, he did it the easy way by getting the treble the first dart.
77.
One out the board. Unruffled, unmoved, but not unsteady.
The dart just comes right from his eye, across the top, and one short movement, short quick movement. No other body movement.
100!
I think this has been his play as well, consistency. We just say, not the highest scores, John, but... And the tons and ton pluses really gone to town.
100!
Well, there's two true Scots. Les's mum and dad. Very nervous is wee Jock.
Marshall looks as though he's quite comfortable in the match so far.
60. ...140!
Well, there they are, here again. Good right there. Grenadier Guards and SAS, 77 years of age. We've got Tommy Battle, at 76, the Parachute Regiment, and Eddie Lee, 70. He served with the regiment in Egypt, the Royal Regiment of Artillery. 223 years between them.
140!
Well, we have said, John, throughout the week, it's for the young and the old. Entertainment at the top level.
Les looking to get to the double here. He'll be back to the line again.
140!
Well, it's 44 again, John.
Yes, after 12 darts, so a great leg from Les. handling the pace well.
Leisure require 44.
Took the first leg with four double top. Can't see him changing, but we'll see. Double top. Double 10.
34. Marshall, you require 101.
Oh, good opportunity to win against the darts here. Likely to start on the treble 20. Treble 15. Could be treble 19. Yes, he's gone for the 15s. Can't finish now.
49. Leisure require 10.
It's double 5. The third leg. That's a good marker. Off the barrel right in.
Game shot. And the third leg. Les Wallace.
Well, reaction from the crowd. And a little reaction there
Full
from Leslie.
Marshall, the pro first. Game on.
Well, I've noticed, Tony, that Les is not watching Marshall shoot. He's keeping in his own game.
Yes, it's surprising the players that fall into the trap.
140.
Certainly, he'll hear the scores, John, as he reaches the hockey.
Well, I think the important thing is to keep a track of what your opponent's scoring, but not to become mesmerized watching them throw.
And that is the McWallis Tartan.
64. 45.
The silence of the crowd. Giving the perfect order. There's a very good close-up here. It's the left-hander. Just see the point.
180.
Made his point. Oh, the balloons are going up. There's no Branson. Certainly found the range, haven't they, John?
Yes, both players are shooting quite well.
Down to the 19s for the cover shot.
117.
Oh, he really needed that last treble to get to a finish. Good shot by Les.
Yes, because Marshall only hoping. 140. Another treble would leave him double 18. Just checking the score.
140.
Well, brilliance.
Leisure require 140.
Fully capable. Treble 20 the first dart. Yes. Treble 20 again. Double 10. For the second
shot! And the first shot! Les Wallace!
Well, they have the fans. Marshall James can't believe it. 140. And there they go. Something to cheer. Les Wallace, first set. Remarkable.
Second set, first leg. Marshall to throw first. The very best of order. Game on.
And that. John, that 140 was the shot that Steve Beaton needed to be in the final.
Yes, and missed it by just the width of the wire. And then Marshall capitalized with a high finish of his own.
192!
Well, what a reply, another maximum. Not flustered, though.
100.
Well, looking at this timing, John, Marshall James still around that 20-second mark. Where's Wallace? 12 seconds. That's throughout the championship. And I don't think there's much changed. If no. anything, maybe just a little bit quicker.
Yes, and I don't think the slow pace has affected Les at all here.
60.
But the scoreline reads 1-0 to Scotland. The danger is there.
100.
Marshall's been unflustered by that high finish from Les.
Well, that was a good shot, wasn't it? But unfortunately, not for Marshall.
40.
Often a distraction, John, isn't it?
Yes, but I don't think it'll disturb him too much. He knows it's not his fault. And he's still in control of the leg, really.
Well, level at this point.
100.
2-2-1. And these lads are looking for finishes, or leaving on finishes, from 300 plus.
83.
Yes, they're all out, John. We've seen a lot of these. Robin Hood. But in the first set, it was the maid.
81 from Les.
81 left.
139. Marshall require 138.
A chance now, treble 20. I'll still be looking to leave the double. Probably stay with the 20s at this point.
60. Leslie requires 62.
Once again, Leslie not looking at Marshall James' score, but going now for treble 10. Double 16, first leg, second set. Double 8.
54.
Not the one to miss.
78.
78, John.
Treble 14 to start. It's his favorite. Double 18 now. Precision.
Yes, well, as I say, the circus has been in town all week.
Second leg, Les to throw first. Game on.
So lucky there to save that leg against the darts now.
Yes. Les missed a good opportunity there.
46.
There we are, just taking a look. Les not even bothering to look. And I think that's the way to handle it.
Well, that's right. If you watch, you tend to find yourself becoming more involved with the opponent's game. They will be keeping track of the scores. He has to know where he stands.
But we've had our standards throughout the week and continuing now in the final. Look at this. 95.14 Marshall James, 93.90 Les Wallace. James trailing by the first set. The last time a Scot won this title, 1989. Wee Jockey Wilson was 8 years ago.
134.
But the stars of today that's graced this hockey this week, unbelievable.
100.
Yes, the players this week have just set an incredible standard, Tony. I think that we've seen some of the best, most even matches ever.
Leaves
him on 81. Marshall, no out shot. 180, leaves double top. Some of the Welsh fans that's been here all week as Les goes for 81. Double 12.
57.
With attention.
120.
Treble 20. Or the single. Now the treble. 20 now.
Yes.
The jumping, Tune James is on the trail, 2-0 up.
Third leg, Marshall to throw first. The very best of order. Game on.
Outshot, John. He's had 120. Now throwing to level the sets.
Well, in fact, he's had 12 finishes this week, over 100. Very consistent finisher.
Well, when the opportunity's been there, James has hit them. 100%. We're in the second set. Les, look at that. He's had 11 chances, only at 3.
43.
Came through the qualifying rounds, and John, that is a tough one as well, isn't it? 53 countries taking part.
Well, yes, the caliber of play there is fantastic, but one of the hardest elements of it is you have to play 4, 5, 6 matches in a side of a day, so it's very grueling.
60.
Come on, Les!
I think they've all got the Wallace Tartan.
50.
Most of these players, John, as well, as I say, the trail for the 98 championship already started.
85. Look at the posture there. Totally rigid, not one bit of movement.
85.
Yes, he keeps it looking good now. All the set.
41.
Rock solid.
140.
Not a maximum, but on a finish of 116. And Les now starting to weaken a little.
100.
Northern Ireland's top man, Jeff Wiley, and his wife Rose. Treble 20. Single 16. Double top.
Game shot and a second set. Marshall Jones.
Alan Plan there from Wales, his wife Shirley, their anniversary today, 36 years, but...
Third set, first leg, Les to throw first. Game on.
You've got to look at that set, John. 3-0. Accuracy all the way through.
Right, and 4 for 4 shooting at doubles now.
96.
Second 116 finish of the match.
Leo Lawrence one of the great players from Belgium.
One of the great players this week.
Still 100% on his out shots is Marshall.
80!
We see Marshall James. Three dart average of 96.53. Les Wallace, 91.53. 3 180s between them. Only the third set beginning now.
140!
Peter Hinckley, as I say, they're all here. A gentleman from Australia. Great friendship amongst the players, John. I know we've found that out over the last couple of years.
Yes, and as players, we...
140!
We enjoy this tournament while we're still playing and afterwards as well. I mean, just a great feeling to be here.
Well, the ever-present Adams family. But he was left in the lurch in his first match. Well, he's going away all the way.
It's less starting this leg and Marshall pressuring.
99. Marshall require 141.
Needs a treble 20 to start the combination here. Won't finish this out. It's 101 left.
60. Les require 128.
Could be having a trip to the 18s with the first dart. Yes, 54, leaves him 74. Treble 14. No, he stayed on it, but left him double 10. Double 10 it is. Fast player.
Marshall, you require 81.
Well, he usually prefers treble 15, but I have seen him shoot the treble 19 in this situation, so we'll just have to wait and see. Looks like he's going at the 15 by the eye line. Treble 15. Yes. Double 18.
James Shaw and the first leg. Marshall James.
Still 100% record on finishing. This is
second
amazing.
Second leg, Marshall to throw first. Game on.
14 dart leg for Marshall. I don't think he's nervous.
Well, if we was looking for experience, it was certainly with Les Wallace, but not as now.
100.
Stop reading. It's Carol Wallace.
140.
Well, look at this, Marshall James. 100%, 5 thrown, 5 hit, eye out shots at that. Wyatt Earp would be proud of him.
Opportunity for a maximum.
140.
Well, we just mentioned wee jockey, and there's Mick Brooks from Liverpool. Another lad that was in the lineup. What a lookalike.
Well, I think he'll be a great player in his own right, Tony.
140.
In fact, he is now.
261, 221. One set apiece.
Almost looks as though he's trying to hypnotize that treble 20. Very concentrated.
Well, he's hypnotized me, John.
He's switching down. He'll be in good shape here.
96.
He had a good start to 140s. There's two nervous people. His mum and dad.
Well, Marshall had the darts this leg, so Les will have a good opportunity.
85. Les require 125.
Treble 20. Sorry, ball or the 25. That should be it.
Oh, he's hit a three.
It's the first time I've seen that. Not there, Les. 122 left.
39. Marshall recall 160.
He's done it twice already. Treble 20. Now needs the treble now to leave double 18.
40. Les require 86.
Far better finish. Treble 18's leave double 16. Double 16 for one apiece.
Game shot and a second leg. Les Wallace.
The match is all square. The face is red. The parents cheer. One apiece
third
in sets.
Les to throw first. Game on.
One apiece in sets. Nothing to choose, is there, John?
No, Marshall obviously very comfortable, and Les handling the rate of play.
60.
Well, if you can see those, we've got right at the very top there, Leighton Rees, who's with us today, the great Eric Bristow, five times champion, wee jockey, 1983, qualifier then, Keith Deller. We're in the same position.
140.
Well, they've been playing well against the throw here, both players have. Good 61. Cover shot.
61. If only. That's what they're thinking. How many million players, John, would like to take that home with them?
It is a fantastic thing. And it looks good on the mantle, I'll tell you.
100.
As we stand now, 380, Les Wallace, 261, Marshall James, all square.
140.
20 years of Embassy World Professional Darts. These, the stars of today, and the stars of the future.
121.
Pressure now for Les.
100. Needs to get into the treble.
100.
Yes, a recovery there. Leaves him a shot.
140.
140 apiece. Two treble 20s, double 10. Could go for treble 16, double 16. He's been doing that during the week. 64 left, so another treble 16.
92. Les require 140.
Well, he did it in the first set. Treble 20. Yes. Again. Not this time.
100.
He's left his favorite double, though.
Marshall require 48.
16. Double 16. The double that put him into the final.
Game shot! And the third leg. Marshall
and puts him into the lead. Wales back in front.
Fourth leg, Marshall to throw first. Game on.
2-1 he leads. But it's the sets. That's the scoreline they're looking at. Best of 11. First one to 6.
140. In the match,
though.
Marshall in a very good position now to take the third set.
140.
Well, we've seen records kept from day one, 20 years, and those are the ladies that keep the scores.
Good opportunity for Les now. Well, mentioning records, it's worth noting Mervyn King set a new record for 180s in the championship.
94.
Your uncle Les, they're all here, all his family. How many was it, John? The 180s for, I can't recall it that many.
30 180s, Tony, breaking the record set by Raymond Barneveld in 1995 of 29.
70 yards.
And that took in the final, didn't it?
Yes, so quite an accomplishment by Mervyn King.
100.
Well, he's left 166, so you've got to put Marshall James as a slight favourite here because not an outshot 166. The scoreline that they're looking to have a finish on. 143 left.
100!
Well, not able to finish this. We're looking to get to the double of...
50.
I won't be happy with that.
Marshall, you require 123.
Well, he's looking at Les, 116. Now he'll be looking at 19. Oh, the treble, I would think. 19 leaves 104. Gives him another chance of an outshot. But that's 57. 66. 16 and ball, but try for the treble as well. We've got a shot at the ball. Look at those eyes.
98.
Well, just mashed, obviously. Leslie slightly
Paul,
adrift.
116.
Treble 20 is the start. Now the 16. Double 20.
Yes! Shots in the full play. Les Wallace.
Scotland can cheer. The Ireland fling, they're doing a lot. But there's Marshall.
Fifth leg, Les to throw first. The very best of order. Game on.
Well, that to stay alive in the set, what a shot.
Yes, and it didn't suit Marshall. He was stunned there.
100.
So two apiece. We're in the third set.
12, very little seems to bother Marshall. I'm sure we'll see him right back in the treble, and there it is.
100.
Well, we haven't seen Gromit yet, we've seen Wallace.
40.
Well, that's a true Scot.
100.
Let's just look here at Les as he moves in. Centre of the hockey. Very fluent. Right through with the dart. Looking comfortable.
40.
Well, great opportunity for Marshall now. Les started this leg. Marshall now favoured.
I'm looking at Marshall. Over to our left. Slightly.
140.
Applause for 140, leaves him on 161.
Less fighting back.
100. Marshall, you require 161.
Needs a treble 20. 'll be back to the line, looking to get to the double. That's 80 scored. 80, so 81 left. Treble 15.
125.
Well called, John. Double 18 left. No outshot for Les Wallace.
Marshall, you require 36.
A leg for the set. Double 18.
Game shot in the third set. Marshall jump.
Right in the middle. The Welsh are standing. Their lad is 2-1 in front. The James gang is here.
Full set, first leg. Marshall to throw first. The very best of order. Game on.
Well, Les smiling, wiping his brow. As Marshall gets his underway in this first leg of the fourth set, leading 2-1. And his averages have got higher as the week has gone home.
There's averages there. Marshall James, 98.88 for three darts. Les Wallace, 93.27. Both getting slightly better.
Incredible.
123.
And there's Bob and Barbara Potter. We all call it Potter's Paradise, and really, he has got a complex here worthy of any world championship. He makes sure that everyone's catered for throughout.
100.
But as we look at the scoreline, 77 points behind Leslie. But he's speeding up, John.
140.
That's evidence on that throw.
Yeah, so that's his natural pace. It's harder to step to the line and throw a fast pace when the other player is longer at the hockey. But he doesn't watch, does he? I mean.
No, he looks down at his sparring and that's it.
No, that's the best policy.
Even the kids are on the act.
140.
Cruising.
Yes, the policy taking a course there, speeding up his action.
100.
Well, there's a character for him before him, the Viking. The lad from Woolwich. Double 19 we're going for.
79. Marshall, you require 101.
Starts with a treble 20. Okay. The 9. The double 16.
Let's require 19.
Could be 3 double 8. Yes, now 8. Good marker.
11.
Well, double troubles.
Marshall requires 16.
Won't rush this lad, I promise you. 8. The stare. The second dart. Moves over the hockey. And that's the area he has to aim for. 8.
No score.
Well, 16.
Yes, caught between the other two barrels.
8.
4 for Les. Yes.
Shaw on the first leg. Les Wallace.
Carol back in the groove as is her husband. Marshall stares.
Second leg, Les to throw first. Game on.
Yeah, I think he missed more darts at a double there, Marshall, than he has throughout the match, John.
Well, I'm almost positive of that. Less hot.
140.
Nothing ever seems to bother him, though, Tony. Always comes back to the line. Goes about his business.
100!
I'm just looking there. After those darts for double 16, double 8, 12, 7, still with an average of 58.33 is James.
84!
And Joanne Williams and Rachel Baxter. I say it's become a wives' club this week, John. Ollie's still here.
Yes, they run the show.
Two consecutive hundreds. Marshall James.
190.
One caution to the wind. And there's Ronnie Baxter and Paul Williams. Great leg from Wallace, but back comes Marshall James.
100. Elizabeth Quan, 96.
Treble 20. Double 18. Double 9.
87.
No finish for Marshall, though.
But to put a man under pressure, wanting 9, a good score will do.
100. I think he really needs to treble the pressure less.
60.
144 the shot. See, speeding there.
Marshall required
141. These are Hans and Shirley. As I say, their anniversary today. 36 years and he's never missed a championship. 81 left. Treble 10 leaves double 16. If he gets a go.
89. Let's require 9.
He's the one to get to the double 4. Yes, he's had it this time. Double 4.
One score.
Back to James.
After you require 52.
Shaking the heads out in the audience, but 12 leaves double top. Double top.
Game. Secondly,
the difference in the match. Look
third
at Les there.
Marshall, throw first. Game on.
I can't believe that. I wonder if that will distract him a little bit, John.
Yes, well, Marshall gave him the first leg, and he gave Marshall back the second. So maybe a bit of nerves starting to tell in this final.
41.
He's certainly got his chance to get back in front here.
45.
There's Tanya James.
140.
To apply pressure.
Yes, and Les failing to capitalize in a bad start by Marshall. Marshall took the initiative.
100.
He's definitely rushing the darts through. 36 points ahead, plus these three.
60.
I think the crowd play a big part, John, as well, don't they?
97.
You know, giving the best of order while play is in progress.
Yes. They certainly are able to concentrate.
44.
One or two twitchy fingers in this leg.
Yes, well, Lessell has a chance to get to be the first one to the finish. He might need a 19 now.
Yes, good thinking, Lessell.
That's a 19, didn't he? Trouble.
Marshall on 215. Good shot needed, the pressure less. 25 would leave him 167, so he might go for a treble 20 or the bull. All right, he's gone the 20.
20 yards. There's a 122.
It'll be 18s. So 54 left. 54 scored.
68 left.
68. Went for 48, double 10.
82.
He knows Marshall can't finish, but being encouraged still from Tanya.
Treble 17 now, to leave double 8.
137. Is required 40.
Double top. Double 10.
20.
Doubles deserting him.
As you require 50.
18 or 10. He prefers double top. That's what he's looking at. Double 10.
40. Leisure require 20.
Double 10 now. Double 5. Good marker.
15.
Well, the heat may be getting through to them. The headaches.
Require 10.
Options here, double 5. Third leg. Fourth set. Oh, wrong bet. Well, it's all happening, John. We've had everything.
Yes, he's the one to leave the double 2. Double 2.
Yes! And the third leg. Les Wallace.
Cheers all round. Wallace, 2 on ahead. Fourth set.
Fourth leg, Liz to throw first.
Well, they're just having a little chat there, asking each other, who is it to go first? Well, our referee will, sorts that out for us.
100.
Strange leg, that last one.
Yes, well, every leg this set has been a bit nervy. I guess just the length of the match. The importance of this being the final really starting to sink in. Both players playing well.
94.
What was your thoughts in this position, John, when you won the title, this stage?
Well, my experience was the final was at least twice as hard to play as any other match. It's epic, really.
100. Perfect stance, perfect throw.
100.
Well, them's the kids that's watching them, and that's the stance to look at. Much more fluent, much more natural.
100.
There's Leslie.
Marshall not able to leave a finish at this point, but can still pressure.
84.
And a finish on here.
161.
Treble 20, treble 17. 81 left, treble 19 for double 12.
99.
Leaves him 62.
And in great position to take the set. Marshall looking to apply the pressure, though. The way this set's been going, anything could happen.
60.
He's on a finish.
Let's require 62.
Treble 10 leaves double 16. 12 leaves double top. Double top for the set.
22.
Right on the wire.
Marshall, you require 161.
Could this be it? Treble 20. And then for treble 17. Has to go for treble 17 and ball. 161, ball. Oh, fraction jobs.
Where's the record? 20.
Double top for the set.
Going yes. In the shot in the full set. Les Wallace.
Well, Carol and all his friends are applauding, but that 161 shot, that would have rattled it along if that had gone in. But it's two sets apiece as we go on.
Fifth set, first leg. Les to throw first and go to the best of order. Game on.
Some wonderful banners around the crowd, John, isn't it?
Yes, the love of the game showing through all over this auditorium.
97.
Well, looking at it now at 2-2 apiece, Marshall James 93.01, Les Wallace 90.05. Do you think they can keep that standard up, John, throughout?
I think you'll see this go up. I think the averages will be at least 3 or 4 points higher by the end of the match.
100.
You know, we talk about the crowds and people here. It's the first time I've seen touts outside.
100.
Barbara Potter.
Ever consistent.
140.
Gives him 261. But Les in the driving seat.
100.
Well, 100 would give him another chance for that 161 out. More importantly, the first opportunity for the finish.
100. I 84.
Good
Marshall
save.
Require 161.
That's the finish. He missed to save the set. This time. 121 left.
100. Les require 120.
Got him as a deputy now, Mac Danger. Needs the treble, doesn't John?
Yeah, he's just been low.
60.
Marshall James.
61.
61. Could be treble 15, maybe the 25. Gone for the 15, that's 46 left. 14 would leave 32. Double 16 for the first leg of the fifth set.
45. Leisure requires 60.
20, double top. There's the 20. Now the double top.
Game shot in the first leg. Les Wallace.
Scotland ahead. Wales.
Marshalls and throw first. Game on.
But only the advantage of the throw.
Yes, well, that's three legs on the trot for Les. So perhaps a bit of a momentum gain for Scotland.
94.
The first two sets, Marshall James 100%. He's now drifted to 44.44. So that's the area where he's been losing the legs.
100.
Look at that sight, John. Familiar, isn't it?
Yes, it's been the same all week.
40.
Yes, we've had some wonderful scenes. Tears of joy, tears of sadness.
You can see from the Cyclops, the great 100. Audience in the back. Look at that. Imagine looking out at that before you have to hit a double.
Yeah, she wouldn't get bored, would you, John?
$124.
And Captain Marvel there, Martin Adams. I mean, that started the week off, didn't it?
$140.
That match against Roger Carter.
And that's the first match of the week, and it was a beauty.
$81.
Puts him on a finish.
$161.
Yes, but Les first. Treble 20. Yes, treble 17. 19s.
$81. Marshall require $160.
Needs two treble 20s to leave the double 20. A good start. Yes. Double 20 for 160 out.
120.
Right on the wire is Alan Glazier. The man in black looks on at Les Wallace. Double 10 for 2-0.
Game shot in the second leg. Les Wallace.
Well, it's incredible scenes. Marshall James had it there, 160. But he's trailing 2-0, fifth set.
Third leg, Les to throw first.
Well, Les coming up, coming off a 14 dart leg, has the throw, looking in great condition for this set.
We have a break after this one, John, don't we, after five sets?
129.
Les might not want a break the way he's throwing now.
140.
What's the feelings, John, when you went out there after, you know, after five sets in your final?
97.
Well, I was in quite good position, so I was very anxious and just wanted to try and keep focused on and just to get in the one more set.
94.
Yes, Bob enjoying the action. Been working all week. Entitled to have a break.
65.
Marshall could be first to the out here.
Well, he needs this one to save the set.
Oh, and an unfortunate dart. Now he needs to get a treble.
81.
He won't have a finish.
As you can see there, on the indicator board, 185, 210.
90.
Les looking very comfortable.
Yes, much more relaxed now with this faster throw. It's produced in the last couple of sets.
41. Les require 112.
Turn into the break. 3-2 ahead. Single 12. Double top. For the sets.
Game shot in the fifth set. Les Wallace.
Well, we'll be taking a break to this. Cheers. The pandemonium now. It's Les Wallace. 3-2 up.
There will now be a 5-minute interval.
Grossing 65 minutes or so of darts, but it's Les Wallace of Scotland who goes into the interval just holding that slight advantage, 3-2, but he did take that fifth set very comfortably, 3-0. Well, in the studio with me here backstage at the Lakeside, not only Bobby George, but Steve Beaton, last year's winner, of course, who's a reigning world champion, is very nearly about to end. Steve, how is it watching the final rather than playing it?
Well, obviously, I'd like to, I'd love to have been up there. I mean, great, but I don't know. I mean, the game's going great now, and
is the man who beat you, Marshall James, going to come through and win it as a qualifier, do you think, and what you've seen so far?
He's a leather, don't give in. I mean, yesterday proved it. He just doesn't give in. I mean, you can get ahead of him and he'll still keep coming back. And even though he's 3-2 down now, I still can't see him giving in. I think he'll still keep coming back at Les now. And oh, God knows what'll happen in the end, but, you know.
Well, nobody knows. Everybody keeps saying, well, Les maybe should win it. But on the evidence so far, you really can't say that with any confidence, Bobby, can you?
No, Marshall doesn't give up, like Steve said. If you've got 220 and you've got 60, you go out a big one, you miss and he goes out. And that's all that's happened through the game he played against Steve. But Les is missing shots himself. When he wanted 9, he thought, mustn't hit the big 20. That cost him the set, basically. And then Marshall done the same thing. When he wanted 5, he looked at the 2, and I thought he's going to go 2, 4. The worst thing he can do is change your mind.
Sure.
And that cost him
the... But the old pendulum is swinging, if you like. Les takes the first set, then begins to struggle in the doubles. Marshall moves ahead, and then, as we've just seen, Les comes back again. And I think we maybe suspected, Steve, it would be that kind of final, that they would both have their moments.
Yeah, I mean, Les is, plays the same as me. He likes playing fast, and... I mean, maybe he's finding it a bit hard up there. You know, it's very hard when you got to like about half a minute or a minute between throws.
He's not watching.
I've noticed
that he's maybe not even looking at Marshall now.
It's hard. I mean, I've been sitting in the audience now, and I've been watching Marshall's every dart, and my head's like sort of going like. But you know, I mean, that's the way Marshall plays. You know, he plays a steady game, and you know, it's hard to say which way it's going to go in the end. I mean, I wouldn't like to say honestly.
Marshall was a little bit unlucky in the fourth set, Bobby, that fourth leg. It had been a funny sort of a set. They were both missing doubles, and then he had the chance of the 1-6-1 out and was awfully close to getting it. Let's take another look at that now. Here it is. What do you think, Bobby?
Well, I bet Les thought, he's in at the 51. Look at Les's face. Oh, I thought, yes. He thought, please, miss. I bet he said, please, miss. Oh, it's
and he only just did.
That's a little bit of luck.
That was right on the wire for the 1-6-1 out. Les gets another chance at double tops. And there it is. And that, of course, is what can happen so easily. It's going to come down to doubles. It always does, Steve. Marshall has been so strong all week on the doubles, but maybe signs today that losing it a little bit. Are you not convinced about that?
No, because I watched the first couple of sets there, and I think he hit five out of five. His average was 100%. He didn't miss a double, and then he had a couple of darts there, and he missed a few. But Marshall's so steady, he concentrates on every dart he throws, and I think in the end, if he keeps his concentration, then you know maybe he'll get to Les in the end. But I hope Les keeps his mind together and wins, you know.
Certainly not fazed by the occasion, that's for sure. In fact, neither of them has been at all disturbed by the fact that this is a World Championship final. And we'll be back in just a moment when the players re-emerge onto the Lakeside stage. 3-2 Les Wallace leads at the halfway break. Now, at this time every year, we of course take the chance to look back over the events of what again has been an enthralling week here at the World Championship. Some of the sights and sounds coming up for you of Lakeside 97.
Which planet you are?
Pluto.
Les Wallace hoping not to be brought to back to Earth for a little while longer. 3-2 up at the halfway stage in this Embassy World Championship final. Bobby Jordan, Steve Beaton still with us. Let's take a look at some of the averages so far and the match statistics in this final. Ton pluses, pretty close. 33 is against 30 in favour of the Welshman. And when you get to the 140s, well, it's Les who edges ahead. And only 4 180s so far. A certain well-known Ryder Cup golfer asked me this morning whether there would be 13 or more with a view to him having a wager. And it's not looking too good for him just at the moment. Only 4. Check out statistics. Les Wallace has thrown 35 and only hit 11. He could be well clear with a slightly better average. But, of course, Marshall has hit 8 out of 19. Slightly better average at 42.11. They're always interesting, those statistics, Bobby. Do you pay a lot of attention to them? Does it tell you much?
The doubles now, they don't. It's, the guy's got more, he's more accurate on his doubles on the figures there, but he's behind in the sets. Mm. So at the end of the day, it's I don't really like it, to be honest with you.
Really?
Nah, I'll do it for a living. I still don't understand that. I mean, I can understand a fella having like 101 average like per dart, but when it becomes like 33.3 something recurring on a double, I'm lost. To be honest with you.
Steve, it's 3-2. It's 3-2 to Les. This next set, obviously, is going to be awfully important because there is a big difference between leading 4-2 in a final and being pulled back to 3-all, isn't there?
Oh, it's nice. Nice to go in the break now. Les can relax for about 5-10 minutes now and come out fresh. He's 3-2 up. You know, he's got the upper advantage. And I mean, I wish Les all the best, but, you know, Marshall is a grinder and... You know, at the end of the day, it's the one that holds his head up high and don't give in.
He did it to you, and you've just got a feeling he might do it to Les as well, haven't you?
Well, I just hope Les doesn't give in, just keeps his head up and just keeps banging away.
All right, let's find out then, because the players are standing by, ready to be reintroduced to this sell-out Lakeside audience. Let's rejoin our commentators, John Parr and Tony Green, and firstly, of course, our compere, Martin Fitzmaurice.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back Marshall James! Les Wallace!
Well, they're on the stage. They've had the break. It's Les Wallace 3-2. Before the break, they've been playing 1 hour and 5 minutes. So in the 10 seat, a tense battle. Practice starts here, but only 3 on the return, normally 6 on the first start. But that's the ruling laid down by the British Darts Organisation. As always, it's great to have professional comments from my friend, John Parr.
Well, thank you, Tony. Looks like they're just taking a look at the board here. Make sure they're both happy with it.
And there's a nice shot of Jim Sweeney. The BDO officials has been here from day one. There's the Cyclops camera there, John. Gives us that lovely view.
Yes. Looking right back at the players as they shoot for the double 20.
Both players must agree that the board needs moving. Les is still not happy. He said it's not right for a left-hander. It might be all right for the right. Got to be perfect.
Well, Les told me he practices on a left-handed board.
All right.
Yeah, they're both to agree. And they're happy. So no practice starters yet, and plenty of time while Marshall throws his 3. So John, it's 3-2, what's it looking like?
Well, 3-2, but after a break, I mean, that's as even as it could be, isn't it? I mean, not much has separated these two players. Both have come out showing that they've got what it takes to hit the double under pressure, to make the scoring happen. I think we can see
you,
a bit
gentlemen.
Of an increase, though, in their averages.
Six
I think we'll see them
leg.
Come out and even do
Marshall
more than they have.
Came on.
And to take us through the next 6 sets, hopefully, is Martin Fitzmaurice. Well, that's a good start, considering John, because he's going to win this set. He has the advantage.
Yes, well, as I said, I guess it's as even as it could be after a break, and Marshall with the throw to get it back to 3-3 in sets.
Well, I mentioned the heat, and Les already feeling it.
96!
Here we go. On the match, 92.94. Marshall James, 91.27. But only four 180s, two apiece. And I think that's a little bit of tension in the arm, John, isn't it?
Yes.
140!
Well, it's the tension of being in the final. The greatest dart match anyone could ever be in.
There's the lads, the old Chelsea pensioners. They love it here every year. And look at them medals. Well, there they are. I wonder how many darts championships he won. If you don't get them playing darts, I promise you.
60.
But as we look at the scoreline, it's Marshall James now. And it's the first leg of the sixth set. Leading the way.
An impressive stat so far, Tony, is... To this point, we've had 180s scored in this championship.
140!
Yeah. 180s.
96! Marshall, you require 76.
Total 20, double eight the shot. Seventy-three, travel 19, double eight. 54 left. Single 14 leaves double top.
36.
That's needing a big score here.
82.
Interesting switch.
40.
Yes, double top.
Yes, that's a first leg. Marshall James.
So the breakdown, James, no harm at all.
Second leg, Les to throw first. Game on.
First leg with the advantage. The danger. First in the second.
123.
Well out of the gate. Check out stats, Marshall James, throwing 20 at double, hit 9 of them, 45%. Les Wallace throwing 35, hit 11,
31.43. 60.
Gives you some indication how the course of the match is taken, John, doesn't it?
Yes, well, as we remember, Marshall came out and hit his first five shots at double, but 45%, an outstanding...
Average. 132.
Got the scoring in this leg going with Leslie. But here's a shot of concentration, not a flicker.
100.
Puts him on a good out.
40.
Yes, 106. Needs all three there.
180. Legend required 106.
Treble 20. Yep. Six. Double top.
66.
Well, that 180.
Marshall, you require 161.
Let's give the Marshall a chance at treble 20, treble 17 ball. Treble 17. Oh, 84.
97. Les, you require 40.
It's double top. All square at one apiece in this sixth set.
Third leg, Marshall to throw first. Game on.
13 darts for Les, so the break obviously hasn't affected his concentration.
Well, I think both players have come out all guns firing.
100!
The Marshall especially, John.
Yeah, it's a good indication that they're both sharp, is that both legs have gone with the darts.
80!
Well, they're certainly not bored. Well, darts on top of the world.
Well, darts are headed in the right direction.
100!
120 points behind is Les Wallace. The blue and the white of Scotland.
Looking for a big score here, get to a finish. Yes, 180 available.
140!
Yes, still no shot after 140. Marshall James, though, will certainly be on a finish. Not a very good first start below the wire, so moves across the hockey, trying to get over the top. Brilliant.
100!
Les can only hope now. He needs to get a good score, leave himself with a nice finish, and see what
100.
Marshall does.
It's not bad, 81.
Marshall, you require 101.
These are the ones that count now. The finishing line, treble 20 to leave 41. 41. Single 9 leaves double 16. Only the one dart, and it's double 16.
Yes, that's the third leg. Marshall James.
Absolutely clinical. The badge is shining.
Game on.
Well, a nice 15 dart leg there.
140.
Consistency from Marshall James. 4 100s scored in a row, and then the 101 finish.
A good start from Wallace. But it should be leveled or bettered.
140!
Certainly the break, I think, has relaxed both players, John.
Yes, well, they'd been out on the stage for an hour and 5 minutes before the break, and really it is hot up there.
93!
Chance to cool down and reflect, and it's benefited both of them.
There he is. Left hand side of the hockey.
60.
First appearance as referee this week, Martin Fitzmaurice.
100.
That's all the cards. All the dolls, all the toys, all out today. The final.
85.
It's a handy dragon there to have.
100.
A nice finish. Marshall James looking for the maximum. Leave the double. 100. He's going to be on a good finish here. Les will be under pressure.
100! Les will require 68.
Treble 20. No, he's gone for 48. So, double top now.
48.
Unusual.
Marshall, you require 116.
This for the set. He's done it twice already. Treble 20. still has a shot, needs the treble 20. Well, let's stay there to try and leave double 8.
16!
Nope. Les.
Les required 20!
Pounce in the hockey, looking at double 10. Double 5, can't afford to miss this one.
Yes, that's a first leg! Les Wallace!
Well, you can see the fans here for Wallace.
Fifth leg, Marshall to throw first. Game on!
One that really matters as far as James is concerned. He was favourite, having started the first leg of this set. Needs this leg to make it 3 apiece.
85!
And every leg since the break has gone with the darts, so good position for Marshall.
Against Paul Williams, it was Les Wallace who was taking that final leg of each set. Each set going to 2-2.
Each of these players has done so well under that ultimate pressure, that last double, the most important double, all through this championship.
16!
There he is. Such a good action. Full flow of the arm. Steadiness of the body.
100!
You know, you might see these players miss a double in the first or second leg of a set, but I don't think either one of these guys have missed in the fifth.
Awkward, that first out under the wire, to get over the top.
100!
Just keeps him in this leg. Certainly doesn't want to go 4-2 down.
No.
140!
You want to stay within a set.
There it is. The champion will hold that aloft with pride. Les on 1-6-2, so can't finish with 3.
86!
170, Marshall James. We've seen that outshot.
Les making a bit of a mess of this. Saves
65.
It, though.
65! Marshall, you require 170!
Les Wallace, is it 170? 60. In the background.
60.
Can't wait to get to the hockey.
Les, you require 97.
Treble 19. We're now treble 18 to leave double 20. Yes. Double 20.
77.
Pulled it.
Marshall, you require 110.
For the set. Treble 20 leaves 50. Treble 18. Always pulled that one as well. Nerves creeping in.
78. Les, you require 20.
For the sixth set, double 10. Double 5. Good marker. Yes!
Yes! That's a sixth set. Les Wallace.
Well, there's Les fans out there watching. Les Wallace has gone 4-2 up in sets. Last two legs on double 5. It's got them all going.
Seventh set, first leg. Les to throw first.
Well, 4-2. Wallace resumes because he'll be throwing first, having taken that last set against the darts.
Game on.
A great position to be in. But I think we heard Steve Beaton say,
thank you, ladies and gentlemen, please.
Marshall James won't give in. That was a great set for Marshall, John.
134!
And for Les, Marshall James there. Look at that. Three dart average, 92.99. Les Wallace, 91.50. Three 180s, Marshall. Two for Les.
Standards still high.
140!
And this cauldron. Well, I hope he doesn't get a false sense of superiority here.
Yes, 4-2, not an insurmountable lead. There is breathing room for Marshall James. Coming up very strong, Marshall, this set.
85!
Against the darts now, he's in control of the leg, Tony.
Yeah, we've had some great Welshmen in this championship throughout the years. Well, there is one. Great mate of mine. We've travelled the world together. The 1978 champion. Look at that smile. Never changes.
180!
Well, this has changed it all around. Has to go out. Treble 20, still a chance. Treble 17 is looking at Les Wallace's score, not his own. Les is on 42, so treble 17. He's done it now, the bull.
96!
Back comes Wallace, Carroll looks on.
42.
You go for two double top. Double top is favourite.
Yes, that's the first leg. Les Wallace.
You can't get any cooler than that.
Second leg, Marshall to throw first. Game on. Thank you.
So at the moment, it's a parade for Scotland's Les Wallace.
The Marshall's still in town.
100!
And we see Marshall James throwing 22 at double, hit 10, 45.45. Les Wallace, 46 throw and hit 10.
96!
And earlier in the week, we had a message from Phil Bennett, great Welsh Rugby Union international. So that this young man had a great future in the game.
180!
Tanya, that is joy.
That is fourth 180 of the match.
98!
Never gives in.
180,
140.
Well, Marshall in great shape here for
125.
11 or 12 dart game.
Marshall, you require 81.
Treble 19 or treble 15 here to start it. 66 left. May go for the treble 10. He's hit the 25, that's 41 left.
He's 54.
Tries a different way of finishing, one or two variations.
He will be back to the line, so just as a matter of how much pressure.
76. Marshall, you require 27.
27, 11 leaves double 8. Double 8 for the leg.
Yes, at the second leg. Marshall James.
Back into rhythm, back into the swing.
Third leg, Les to throw first. Game on. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Best of order, please.
But the main one he has to take is the one against the darts. Because Les is leading the way.
117.
not showing any daylight.
These legs when he needs to really put on pressure, doesn't he, Wallace?
Yes, and certainly Marshall must win this set. He wouldn't want to be down 5-2. He'd have to win 4 on the trot then.
81!
Just staying there. 4 points ahead, but once again, Les favourite.
80!
I've noticed Les is watching Marshall play much more now.
140!
Well, he's seen some great scores, that's for sure, if he is.
He can't finish, but he can certainly leave a good finish.
100!
Yes, it's 104.
Marshall, you require 140!
2 treble 20s, double 10. For the lead in this set. 8 treble 20 to leave double top.
45. Les, you require 104.
Options here, treble 20. He'll stay there. He can't finish now.
100.
Les double 2.
Marshall, you require 95.
Surely 25 or the ball. Yes, 25 taken off. So treble 20 or the single. He now needs ball. Just 70. Pulling them down a bit.
Les, you require 4.
Double 2.
More pressure applied to that man there, Marshall James.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Fourth leg, Marshall to throw first. Game on.
A leg he must take to save the set. Les Wallace leading 4-2 in sets.
$100!
That's here. Nice for Hampshire County throughout the year.
$100!
There's Marshall, Pembrokeshire, in the fourth division of the county leagues.
Marshall showing a little more emotion in his face 60. Than he has before.
7'9¼.
42.
Oh, that's a rare score in this final.
Marshall should be relaxed by that, really taking the pressure off of him. Yes, and he has taken advantage.
100!
Les can relax, though. Even if he loses this leg, he will still have the throw for the set in the fifth.
97!
So quite a bit of work for Marshall yet.
Let's head over the top. Oh, off the wire. That could be a vital dart.
40.
201, only 61 points ahead.
Yes, Les Wallace certainly able to finish 262 in 6 darts. Yes, a good start. Might need an 18.
100.
Oh, didn't think it through.
No, he's not thinking John, is he? 18 there would have left him 164, whereas he has six darts to go.
I think he's just so confident he's going to hit the treble 20. He doesn't care. Oh.
81 left. Treble 15 the shot.
135!
Should have been throwing at a 164 finish, really. 42 left.
130!
Pressure now.
Marshall, you require 66.
Option. Bull leaves double 8, treble 10. We'll leave it with him. Went for the bull. Is it 17? So 49, another 17 leaves him double 16. He's allowed to ask. And they go for 9 double top. This changed, yes. Double top.
26.
A vital miss.
Leslie require 32.
He keep his calm. Hit double 16. He goes ahead 5-2.
Yes! That's a 7-6.
So there we are, he sweats, he stands, there's nothing he can do, he's 5-2 down to Les Wallace.
First leg, Marshall to throw first, game on, thank you.
This eighth set with a formidable task, a mountain to climb, there's plenty in the valleys, but John,
100!
Double top miss.
Yes, a key shot. Look at the averages here. Marshall, still three dart average, 93.64. Les, 91.89. The better 60. Average isn't helping him, though. Les hitting the crucial doubles.
Three countries took part. Over a million players. The remaining two. Les Wallace leading 5-2 in sets.
100!
Oh, it gets awfully hard to concentrate with needing to win four sets on the trot.
60!
Well, his concentration has to be to take this one.
59.
By the same token, it becomes hard to concentrate when you're one set away from becoming the world champion.
And that's from the man who took the title. 1994. 60. Steve Beaton had a great year as the Embassy World Professional Champion. What a great year he had. Still in love.
100!
Good position for James in this leg, John.
Yes. He hasn't given anything away. Spoke too soon.
Yes, should have been a better finish. 136, three darts, but Les can't finish on 182.
43.
Well, two treble 20s would leave him double 8.
Still with 100% concentration.
Well, if he puts himself on double, he'll still be looking pretty good. He's wondering why it's happening to him.
35.
Yes, he's had two darts on the floor.
Leslie
well,
require 139.
The laird of the manor at the moment. 110 left, 29 scored.
44. Marshall, you require 101.
Treble 20. It's 41 left. Could be 9. Yes. Double 16.
85. Les, you require 95.
Will it be 25 or the bull or treble 19, double 19? is it the ball? So 45 left, double 16 with the last dart.
Yes, that's the first leg. Les Wallace.
A great finish. That will get poor Marshall James into more and more difficulties.
Second leg, Les to throw first. Game on.
The cheers subside. Les Wallace takes the first leg. Eighth set against the darts.
Les with all the momentum, he's won the last three legs.
134!
The crown coming ever closer. Looking at the checkouts, well, 42.31. Les Wallace, 36. But vital doubles missed in these latter stages from the James boy.
140!
100% concentration still from James.
$122.
Les giving away nothing here. He's looking very strong. Knows he has the advantage, this leg.
But as a true Welshman, John, they never give in.
$140.
Two 140s in this leg. And playing under all sorts of pressure. Les deciding which way to go.
41.
Well, there's the chance Marshall needed to take this leg. Not on a finish, but in good shape here.
Come
on, 45. Les Sonny, the man that's made it all possible for Les. Pays for all his travel around the world, picking up the points to get to this championship.
85.
No finish for Marshall. 80. Throwing a little faster than he was at the beginning of this match.
60.
I'm on 1-6. Legend
require 119.
Single 19. He's got 57, so 62. Could go 12 and ball. No, he's gone for the treble 10. Maybe a little bit silly there.
79. Marshall require 116.
And Marshall's had this with success. Treble 20. 16. Double top to level the set.
Oh no, he's just failing at the last hurdle.
Les, you require 40.
It's double top for 2-0. Oh, wrong bed.
32.
Nerves at the latter stages.
Marshall, you require 20.
Has to get this, John.
Must. Double 10. It's a good marker. Yes!
Yes, that's the second leg. Marshall,
it's one apiece. The battle continues. Braveheart against Dragonheart.
Third leg, Marshall to throw first. Game on.
Les missing the great opportunity to go up 2-0 in the set. When you have that trophy in your sights, sometimes you just get a little too excited.
Now
you can see it standing long. It'll be standing aloft. And at the moment, it'll be this man who will be holding that wonderful trophy.
44.
Mum and Dad just can't stand it. Wavering.
82.
And a good recovery, John.
Yes, well, both players definitely feeling the pressure for different reasons.
looking down the hockey, looking at a man under pressure, and still that concentration not waning. Trouble now. So cool. Yeah, so that could be the darts of the championship.
Well, that's 4 180s each, but the important thing now, less in striking distance, to be one leg away.
177, looking for a handy finish. Bent the wire there.
60.
Still a glimmer. Still a chance.
I think he needs at least a 140 here. A chance at it. Leave 100.
100.
It is 140.
Legend
Kyle, 117. Trouble 20 leaves 57. Trouble 19 leaves double top. Trouble 18.
57.
John.
Marshall, Kyle, 140.
I'll leave it with you.
Two treble 20s. Oh, the pressure telling. Good recovery. 19s now. Nope.
74. Legend require 60.
Is it the hockey? He's throwing at 20 double top. Double top.
Yes, that's the third leg. Leg
one. Well, the cheers ring out because Marshall James is one leg away from losing this final.
Fourth leg, Les. To throw first. Game on.
He's not sure, isn't James? But guaranteed. A sip of water. Cheers ringing out. The advantage of throwing first.
100.
How do you see it, John?
Well, it's incredible pressure on Marshall now. He's throwing faster than he has been. Just desperate to take this leg and stay alive.
140!
Well, I told you, they never give in, the Welsh. Still battling away. Look at that close-up there. Is he going to be our new champion?
140!
And with darts like that, he's 100 points ahead.
I get the feeling Marshall might only get one more turn. Les getting very hot.
He is really rushing through. Not even thinking.
27.
Well, there it is. Chances.
Tanya James. Marshall James. He's battling back. 136.
Marshall, you require 136.
To keep in the championship, two treble 20s. 88. Oh, he pushed the wire.
128. Legend require 153.
Opportunity for the championship. Treble 20. Won't happen this turn. Good cover shot. He's on double.
131. Marshall require 8.
And it's one last fling from James. Double 4. He's there. He keeps his ult alive.
Marshall James.
Under all sorts of pressure, the Welsh there still cheering.
Fifth leg, Marshall to Rofus. Game on.
And John, what a difference a set could make.
Yes, winning against the darts to stay alive. Now he has the throw. His future's looking much rosier.
Well, I've seen nothing like this man. He's been under pressure in the last few sets, in the last couple of legs. Three 140s.
96!
There he is, rock solid at the hockey. Former junior international rugby player, stands 6 foot, now. One of the top players in this world of darts.
Just looking to get to the double. Yes, 101 left. Switching down to the bottom of the board. Hit an odd number.
97. Marshall required 84.
Trouble 20. Double 12 for the set.
Yes! That's a seventh set.
Well, is this the comeback trail? Les was looking there for the first time.
Ninth set, first leg, Les to throw first. Game on.
Is that the hockey? Is already underway. But the scoreline.
81.
5-3. Match stats, as we can see, Marshall James still in front, 92.98, Les Wallace 90.66. John, the standard of this final, remarkable.
Yes, and the pressure, the performance under pressure, just fantastic.
44.
But we have a fight on our hands. All the darts are falling out of the sky.
He looks on top of his game again, Tony.
100!
Seems to relish the pressure.
Yes, well, certainly Les got a little overexcited at the prospect of being one leg away. Had a few loose darts, and it cost him the chance.
140!
Now fans will be pleased to hear that we will be staying with this live transmission until the end of the match. Can't leave it.
100!
Well, Les coming back with a great leg here. Marshall, though, looks like he's ready for a maximum.
140!
Just on the wire.
Still.
Les require 96.
Les's left hand, double 18.
Yes, that's the first leg. Les Wallace.
So it's the Scots fighting back.
Second leg, Marshall to Rotha. Game on.
Has to break serves in this set.
Fifty-four.
Well, there we see the checkout stats. Marshall James throwing 33 at double, hit 14, 42.42. Les Wallace throwing 55, hit 20, 36.36.
123!
And only a couple of doubles away once again from the title. They have something to cheer him out.
Marshall needing to focus in on that treble as he's done so well. Needs to take this leg or fall down to 2-0. In the set.
Ronnie Baxter, Rachel, Joanne in the background. We'll be packing the bags and leaving tonight. But who's going to be leaving with the title?
121!
Looking very good now for Les Wallace.
Marshall letting up a bit here. Nine darts without a treble 20. They've been playing such a long time, it's hard to stay focused.
55!
Well, they're flying high, and so is this man.
60!
272. Wants to bring himself to a finish. Well, 25 would leave him 167, or treble 20 would leave him 132.
140!
It's Peter and Pete.
Legend require 137.
Which is Les Wallace as well. 77, treble 19 leaves double 10 for 137. Double 10.
Yeah!
Never flinched. Never flinched. Look at the crowd here. 137, Carol Wallace. Is her man is one leg
good
away.
Les to throw first. The very best of all time. Game on. Thank you.
The world's best left-hander. En route, especially after this goal, to take the title.
Yes, and up 2-0 in this set. He'll have 3 chances to do it.
Betting on the gunfight at the OK Corral. Marshall James playing his part.
97!
Needed more. Les Wallace now 270 points away.
Going to be on a finish.
140.
It's 130. Yes, you can feel the pressure now building up.
45.
Be a great way to finish. Single 20, but I don't think he's going for it. Wants double top. Yes! 130! Look at him go! Les Wallace, look at the smiles, but that's the man. We say the greatest left-hander in the world, the tears, the cheers. It was a final relished by both players, but we have a new Embassy World Professional Champion, and that man, the Scot, Les Wallace. Well, handshakes. We've come down now. There it is. It's mine. The standing,
thank
applauding.
Thank you. To make the presentations, would you please welcome the Sales and Marketing Director of Imperial Tobacco Limited, Mr. Graham Blashill, accompanied by Mr. Peter Dyke from World Promotions. Ladies and gentlemen, he had to pre-qualify. He's reached the final of his very first embassy to receive a cheque for £19,000. Ladies and gentlemen, from Wales, Marshall James. Thank you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, he's going to receive a cheque later on of £1,600 for the game shot of 170. In addition, he's going to receive a Magnum of Moët & Chandon, the Embassy World Darts Championship trophy, a cheque for £38,000, ladies and gentlemen, Les Wallace!
Proud Scott, the greatest left-hander in the world champion. Carol, with tears in her eyes, emotion spelt all around the world, the Embassy World Champion 1997, Leslie Wallace.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you.
So the Hampshire contingent leads the scenes of celebration here at the Lakeside. The Scot has won the world title. Marshall James's wonderful run all the way through the qualifying competition, through the finals itself, finally comes to an end. He's had a week he'll never forget. But it's Les Wallace, who has entertained us so well over the last 8 days, who finally gets his hand on the Embassy World Championship trophy. With it, of course, goes that cheque for £38,000. And just to make it a complete joy day for Les, he also wins the highest checkout prize, the maximum possible checkout of 170, and that wins him an extra £1,600. As you can imagine, the celebrations will go on long into the night here at the Lakeside. We've seen another terrific week of top-class darts, and at the end of it all, it's the man who reached the semi-finals last year who's gone one better this year. Les Wallace of Scotland is the new Embassy Darts Champion of the World. From all of us here at the Lakeside, thanks for being with us. We look forward to seeing you in 1998. Goodbye for now.